I grew up on Lake Erie. It's been a part of my life my whole life. I am really excited and really proud to be doing Great Lakes water quality research.
The environmental sample processor is what we affectionately call lab in a can. It will take in a sample of water and analyze it for a toxin known as microcystin. It's the compound that caused the Toledo water crisis of 2014.
It's going to be a great enhancement of our harmful algal bloom monitoring program and our ability to provide warnings to water intake managers and the public about the levels of toxicity that are produced by the harmful algal blooms.
This machine, you know, it's intricate, it's expensive. I just personally felt like there was a lot riding on it. I had a lot of, you know, a lot of pride in it. I really wanted everything to go as smoothly as possible, and on deployment day, I was pretty impressed. Things did go fairly smoothly.
This is the first year that we're operationally deploying it. We've had the instrument for about the last 2 years, working out the methodology of being able to detect the particular toxin that we're experiencing in the Great Lakes, the microcystin.
The surface buoy acts as a marker so we know where we deployed it and can retrieve it, but also within that buoy is a modem that allows us to communicate with the machine and the machine to communicate with us as well.
Anybody that's on this project will get emails when it's running. So we turned it on and we all got emails right away saying that it was working, which was pretty fantastic.
Currently, we collect the water from a boat. We bring the water back to the lab. So it takes about a 24-hour turnaround, where this machine will take that from a 24-hour turnaround to a 2 or 3 hour turnaround on a much more frequent basis.
It's the only one in service in the Great Lakes. There's probably maybe a dozen of these instruments in existence and operation. But again, the first one in the Great Lakes. We were very fortunate this year to acquire two additional grants where we'll be able to purchase two new ESP units. So probably within 2 years, we hope to have a network of three units out there, which will give us a better understanding of what's driving the variability of toxicity within the Western Basin.
It's really important to me to have my science be going towards others, be going towards the public, and directly impact my own community where I grew up. That's just really great for me.